Okay, guys, I'm back, and I'm gonna tell you why I'm back. So, hi again, welcome, replay viewers. So, I came on to do a quick scope, and I had something in my head that I wanted to talk about, and I forgot what it was after I pushed the start broadcast button. So, here's what I wanted to remind everybody about. So, as we got the information that the interest rates are going up next year, I wanted to remind people that FHA is the Federal Housing Authority. That is who does most of the first-time home buyer loan products. So, a lot of people hear about FHA a lot. FHA only requires a 580 credit score to buy. So I'm gonna say it again, 580. Thank you. 580 credit score. So I had like a mini back and forth with somebody on this Facebook group because she was like, no. My loan officer told me it was a 620. Okay, so here's what the difference is. FHA is the federal authority. They only require a 580. Individual. Yes, I'm serious. But here's the thing, okay? So FHA requires a 580, but the individual banks can have what they call overlays. So basically, that means the individual banks can require a higher score. So in general, a lot of banks still require a 620. So most of the time, people will say, oh, to get an FHA, you have to have a 620. You don't. You only have to have a 580. So, if you have a lower score, thank you for the hearts, guys. If you have a lower score, then you need to find the right bank because there are banks out there that will allow you to get a home, a mortgage with a 580. Or the other option is this. If you have a low score, something that's closer to 580, you need to put down more money. And a lot of people don't know that. I don't know exactly what that means. A lot of people don't know that if your score is lower or below what most people, yes, and we have a credit repair specialist on. If Akira is still on here, I saw her pop in, but we do have a credit repair specialist who's on here who hopped in. So she's what's your screen name? I forget. Akira, are you still here? If you are a post, she may be gone. We do have a credit repair specialist. So, if your score is low, one of the things that you can do is you can't. My mic should be. Can you hear me now? Let me know if you can hear me. So then I'll tell you what you can do. Okay. So, one of the things that you can do is if you have a lower credit score, you can put more money down. That is how you balance that. And a lot of people don't know that. So if your score is under the 620, some banks that even require that 620 will go lower on that credit score if you've got more money to put down. Because what that says to the bank is you're not as high of a risk as they thought you were. Because you're putting more money down, that means you've got more skin in the game, basically. So if you've got a lower score, put down more money. That's one way to get around it. Other way to get around it is, yes, get a credit repair specialist to help you repair your credit. And it's a little bit more complicated than just disputing items. Disputing items is definitely one way. High score, less money. Yep. There are now FHA does still offer the what we call FHA Plus, which is a 100% loan, meaning you don't have to put down any money. They still have that program. That program never went away. There are still 100%. What we call 100% loan programs available. They never went away. The lenders just don't push them as much as they used to. So you can still get the FHA at a 620 or 640 with no money down. Now, if you're not putting any money down, they're not going to let you go all the way down to a 580 credit score because it's too risky of a loan for them. So your score is definitely going to be high, have to be higher if you want to get a zero down mortgage. Is going to have to be higher for sure. But if you've got money to put down, your score can go lower. And the reason I've been stressing this is because there is a cost to waiting. And I don't think people realize that. So I know a lot of people say, well, I'm just going to wait. I'm going to wait to buy. I don't know. I'm still on the fence, which is completely understandable. But especially now that they've announced the interest rates are going up, every time that you wait, it's for first-time home buyers, yes. It's so FHA and all of the different banks, they always have a lot of different what we call loan products. And that is just a type of loan product. So there's a regular FHA, which requires 3.5% down. There's FHA Plus, which is no money down. They have a couple other ones. You can do an FHA VA, I believe. So there are lots of. Okay, I'm back. Thank you for jumping back in, you guys. So let me do a quick vent right before I go back into the content because I don't like talking bad about my iPhone. I have an iPhone 6 Plus. And for some reason, ever since they keep sending out all these updates, it does not work properly. But the one time that I'm doing a Periscope and I have it on Do Not Disturb, favorites only, it works right. Any other time, it won't let any of my favorites come through. Any other, yeah, well, he said it's because of my husband. No, any other time won't let my favorites come through. So I'm just gonna give everybody a second to see if people can hop back in, and then because I know people had some questions and there were some comments that were flying. So sorry about that. Well, that's what I get for. I do not disturb favorites only, but I need to just. Oh boy. Anyhow, so you're back. Thank you. Awesome. So, yes. Hi, guys. Come on in. Come on in. Replay viewers, thank you. You guys, if this information is good, please share this. Please share it. And I can answer questions. I'm sorry that I got lost. I can answer questions and please share this with your followers, this one and the previous one, because that's where there was a lot of information in that one. So, we were talking about being able to get a mortgage with a 580 credit score. Hello. So, yes, you can do it. If your score is low, you need to put more money down. I'm just doing a recap, you guys. And thank you guys for jumping back in. So, really quick, let me just introduce myself since we have more people here. I'm Rashida Clark and I'm a realtor. And my phone is weird and it's acting up. I'm sorry. But anyway, yes, you can get a loan with a 580 credit score. Ideally, your score is higher, but that is the credit score for an FHA loan, which is typically used by first-time home buyers. It's a very, very popular loan. What I also would suggest is, welcome, Terrence. What I also would suggest is that you look at your state department, wherever you're located. So I'm in Virginia, and the state Virginia Housing Development Authority has, hold on a second. Yes. Sorry. Has, hi, Quan. I got to take a look. They, Virginia Housing Development Authority, we call them VHDA loans. They have really awesome loan products as well, and those products have very, very similar guidelines like the FHA does. So whatever state you're in, make sure you look at the state department and see if they offer loan products. In some states, they may not offer a loan product, but they may offer things like down payment assistance or rate buy down or things like that. Thank you. So you guys, if you have questions about the FHA loan with a 580 credit score. And a 580, you guys, that's low. So that's really low. A lot of people that I run into feel like they have to have like a 700 credit score to buy a house, and you don't. I mean, you know, even if you go to certain banks, you only need a 620. Actually, Wells Fargo, which does the most loans, I think they're number one or number two in the country for loans, they only require 600. So if you're thinking about Wells Fargo, they only require 600. If I have anybody on here that's for VA, do I have any VA buyers? A lot of banks don't even really require a credit score for a VA buyer. And I don't know if people know that. VA is like the best, the easiest way to buy a loan ever. Ever. You're an NC. North Carolina should have some pretty decent products too. Check their website. Hi, you're in Hampton. Welcome. Welcome, welcome. I'm glad you hopped in. VA is the veteran is the military loan. It's a veteran type loan. If you're in the military currently, if you've ever been in the military, I think you had to have served 181 days. My husband's dancing in the background. Stop. He's trying to make me laugh. What's that site? I have to Google it. I don't know that site off the top of my head because I'm not in North Carolina, but I can find it for you. Are you on, if you're on Twitter, just type in yes and I'll go back and I'll message you with that website. Because in Virginia, they have a specific loan program that's really, really good. And then sometimes they also offer grants. Okay. They also offer grants. So like this past summer, our State Department, they were offering that loan and they were offering a 3% grant. Grant that never has to be repaid ever, ever. And it was still like pulling teeth for me to get people to use it. I mean, it was unbelievable. Like, this is free money. This is a free 3%. And it was like pulling teeth. I mean, I got like four people that actually followed through. But I will definitely contact you with that information from North Carolina. Oh, so let me go back to VA really quick. A VA, they're the nicest, the easiest, the most lenient way to get a loan. VA veterans, it's a veteran loan. Military, even if you're reserve, depending on how long you've been reserve, you can qualify for a VA loan. If you have any military history at all, I would suggest you try to use a VA loan. But FHA and VA are very popular loans, especially here. So that's why I wanted to come on and just remind people that you only need a 580. Ideally, your score would be higher than that, but you only need a 580 to qualify. Now, depending on what bank you're using, the bank may ask you to have a higher score than that. But like I said, you can combat that by having a higher down payment. By higher, I mean the FHA typically requires 3.5%. So I would suggest 5%, 7%, 10%, something like that, if your score is really low. Okay, guys. So I appreciate everybody hopping back on. I'm sorry that I got cut off, but if you guys want to, you can go back and check the replay. I don't think so. You need to reside in the home, yes. I don't think that the requirements are going to change. I mean, because I'm pretty sure the credit score at least has been the same since for like a long time. The only things that change are the guidelines on the back end, which the buyer isn't dealing with. But as far as when I say the back end, I mean like how much debt they allow you to have. So typically they're looking for a debt ratio of no more than like 41 to 43%. So basically, debt ratio is your income divided by all of your monthly bills. That's how they determine a debt ratio. So those kinds of guidelines, those are the things that change, but I don't think that the interest rates are going to change like the credit scores and things like that. Because typically when you start seeing the interest rate hike, a lot of people like trying to rush to the market to try to get in before it gets too high. So I don't think so. And I mean, honestly, it's kind of funny because they've been holding interest rates low since 2006, I think it was. And even still, like, there are so many people that are scared to get into the real estate market. You've got people that are scared to sell. You're welcome. You've got people that are afraid to sell. So maybe this interest rate increase will go ahead and encourage people to start to do what they need to do if they're interested in it. Because really, interest rates make a huge difference. They really do in your payment. And, you know, some people think, okay, well, I'll pay more. That's fine. But really where it starts to bite you in the butt is when it starts to price you out of certain types of houses. So if you've got, you know, a dream house in your mind, the higher the interest rate goes, the less likely you may be able to afford it if your income is staying the same. I mean, if your income is growing, then that might work for you. But, you know, if you want, say, for example, a 3-bedroom, 2-bathroom, 2-car garage right now, that's $200,000. If the interest rates go up 1%, you may only be able to qualify for like $175,000, and you can only get 1-car garage and 3 bedrooms and 1.5 bathroom. You see what I'm saying? So that's where the interest rate is important, because you want to make sure you can get as much as you can when you buy. But, I need to do a whole nother scope about being house poor. That's going to be huge as the interest rates start to go up, because people like to try to squeeze as much house out of their budget as they can, and then they end up being house poor. And we don't want to get back to that. We don't want to get back to that. So, anyway, I'm rambling now, but thank you guys for hopping on. Oh, you, I inherited a house and I never bought a house. Yes, that is a great question, actually. Let me just say, so I had to sit up on the end of my bed for that one. So, first time home buyer, if you, what they're looking for, if you've never owned or never been on a loan, they probably would still consider you first time home buyer. That's actually a really tricky question. I've been getting that question a lot recently from people who used to own homes, like before the economy went bad, or they had a home that that was foreclosed on, or was a short sale, or somehow they lost it or had to move out of it, or sold it and never bought again because the economy was bad. But if you've not had a home, if you've not owned a primary residence, that's the right terminology. If you've not owned a primary residence for the last 2 years, I believe it is, you are now considered a first-time home buyer again. Coupon Diva, depending on where, what state you're in, and what lender you use, you probably would still be considered a first-time home buyer as well. Because they're usually looking for people who have actually purchased and gone through the home buying process, getting a loan and all that kind of thing. But you make sure you get a good lender. Get a good lender, and they should be able to finagle that for you with no problem. And you should still be able to participate in the programs. But Atlantic Bay, you guys, is having, you're welcome. Atlantic Bay has, and Wells Fargo, let me throw Wells Fargo in there. They both have grant money available right now, and it's in most states. I can give you guys a list, or maybe I'll post it on my website. It's in most states, and that grant money also does not have to be paid back ever. And that for that program, you don't have to be a first-time home buyer. So if I have anybody on here that currently owns a home that wants to buy again, you're worried that your credit score dropped, all that kind of stuff, that grant program does not have a first-time home buyer requirement on there. And a lot of banks are bringing back programs for second time buyers or third time buyers that have a lower down payment requirement as well. And so we're seeing a lot of these products come back into the market because the market continues to get better and better. So that's a good thing. That is a really good thing. Okay, so my ramble. If you guys have other questions, please let me know. I didn't put my little screensaver up this time because I had already like shut down my computer and all that. And I just like ran to my phone. But I'm on Twitter. And then, of course, my website link is in my bio. And you can contact me directly from there. But otherwise, I'm going to follow up with you guys on Twitter. I appreciate you watching this part two after it was first interrupted. And please share this video with anybody that is interested in buying in 2016, okay? Have a good night, guys.